Because what's happening is we don't understand what's going to get us out of our conditions. You understand that, brother? Quantum is quantum. Right? My brother with the peak coat, the great peak coat. I can't hear you, Max.
Mike?
Yeah. All right, Mike. Do you understand what we teach? We teach that the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are the true Israelites according to the Bible.
That's right.
What I'm about to go into right now is what's going to set you free from everything that has held you down. Our people have been held down in idolatry. Our people have been held down in the false education put forth by this idol right here. Read this.
This is the book of John, chapter 8 and verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
So we had an officer bring this out earlier, but y'all wasn't here when he brought it out, so I feel it's necessary that we bring it out again. The Bible says that you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Free from what? Free from what you've been taught. You've been taught that we have some sort of power. What month is this month? This is February. What do they call this month?
Break it up!
Black History Month. You cannot contain our history into 28 days.
Break it up!
And within this month, they will repeat what? They will repeat the Black Panthers. We had a Black Panther come up here earlier. What do they stand for? Power for the people. Black power. Well, I want you to think about this. What is black power?
Break it up!
What is that? What is black? Are you black, brother? Are you black? My brother Mike, are you black? Come here for a second, my brother. What's your name?
Rio.
Rio, are you black? How did you learn that you were black? Who taught you were black? Your shirt is black. My jacket is black. You are not black. So I'm gonna ask you again. What are you? Are you African American? You African American? Who taught you was African American?
Get out.
Who taught you that? Listen, we are not African American. We were taught this, give me Deuteronomy 28 and 47. We were taught different things to do what? Keep us subservient to this doctrine or this idolatry that this brother pushed. Right? Read that. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 47.
Bring it up.
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart. Listen, I want to go over some curses that's going to describe who the so-called blacks or African Americans are. You're going to understand that the people on this side, right, the African Americans, which are the tribe of Judah, the Haitians, the Jamaicans, right, we are the children of Israel. Certain things happen to us. One thing being, our name was changed, right? We were told that we were black. You can look at your shirt and you look at your skin and see that don't match. We're not black. Give me 37. Deuteronomy 28, verse 37.
Read.
And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations, whither the Lord shall lead you. You hear that? Read it again from the top. And thou shalt become an astonishment. Thou shalt become an astonishment. He's speaking to the children of Israel. He's saying, you're going to become an astonishment. Something astonishing is surprising, like, wow, these people actually live like this. When you go to the book of Willie Lynch, it teaches that there's certain ways to keep African Americans so-called subservient. You give them a certain condition, like living in a pigsty, that's what they're gonna do. They're gonna accept that way of living. In it, I want you to go look it up. You can look it up on your phone. They subscribe different philosophies on how to keep us docile. One way was to allow the so-called black man and woman to live in a pigsty. They would not remove themselves from the pigsty. Instead, they would try to make it homey. Meaning, whatever you give them, they would learn how to adapt to it. They taught you a false identity and you learn how to adapt to it. They told you was a nigger and you learn how to adapt to it. That's astonishing. You don't see the Chinese man accepting what the so-called white man would give them to say that that's you. No, only you see us doing that. Why? Because these curses apply to us. Because we broke God's commandments.
Right?
I'm gonna bring something out to you real quick. Stick around, all right? Read.
And thou shalt become an astonishment,
a proverb.
A proverb. What is a proverb? A proverb is a wise saying. Something to describe you that's derogatory.
Think of some stereotypes. What's a stereotype that describe our people?
Niggas? What about niggas?
Like six things.
Niggas steal all the time.
Niggas want to fight.
That's all they
want to
do. This route is here. They not, can't stay with niggas. They
don't take care of their children. Right. That's a proverb. Absolutely. And a lot of times we believe that. And we live up to that. Right. Read.
And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword.
A byword is a word called outside of your God-given name. Your name is Quan. What if I kept calling you dog? Would you accept that? Hey, dog, come here, dog. Hey.
Oh, boy.
Or boy. That makes you want to fight, right? But us as a people, we accept that. We accept being called black. We accept being called African-American.
Bruh.
Without question.
Bring it out.
We never thought that this is who we truly are. You know why? Because they separated us from our book.
Bruh.
How did they do that? Let's keep reading.
And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations.
You understand that we're not just here in America. You understand that when we in Germany, they call us whatever derogatory names that they call us to describe us, which is outside of our God-given name.
Bruh.
We're everywhere. And wherever we are, they're dogging us out. They're calling us names that are not godly, right? Read.
Whither the Lord shall lead.
The Lord led us here. How did we get here? Check this. Check that out right there. How did we get here? How did we get here into America? You ever heard of the slave trade? What do you see here? This is a cargo slave ship. You see the soles of our folks' feet. This is a depiction of what it was like for us to be on these boats. We came over here like this. This is how we got here. The Lord sent us here. He sent us here because of curses. You understand that, brother? A curse was inflicted on our people because we failed to keep a commandment.
Right?
Read it. Listen to this.
For example, if you put a slave in a hog pen.
You hear that? This is the pig pen I was talking about earlier. Read it.
And train him to live there and incorporate in him to value it as a way of life completely.
You hear that? That sounds something like the ghettos that we live in.
Right.
These ghettos are hog pens.
Right.
A lot of these ghettos, a lot of the systems don't work. Like, if you call 911, what's going to happen? They may come after the fact. I've lived in neighborhoods where so-called white folks lived in, and before a goddamn crime happened, guess what? Police was on the scene. They there, like that. Fire, there, like that. But we get the lowest of everything. Our schools are deplorable. Our houses are deplorable. Do we speak up about it? Sometimes we do, but does any change happen? Change don't happen because we accept it. We say, all right, one or two people gonna stand up and speak, and then we just gonna allow the conditions to continue. Why? Because that's been ingrained in us, right? Or ingrained in us, read.
The biggest problem you would have out of him is that he would worry you about provisions to keep the hog pen clean.
You hear that? We just want a handout. Hey, can I get this to make this situation better? Instead of us standing up together as a unit and changing ours.
Right.
This is ours. This globe is ours.
Right.
You understand that? Give me 2 Ezra. 2 Ezra 6. This is ours.
That's right.
But there's some things that we need to do to maintain what was given to us.
That's right.
You think the Lord gonna give us real power if we not obeying what he told us to do? Something as simple as, look around right now. I want you to look at every man here right now. Every man you see with purple on and fringes on, look at their head. What do you see on their head? You don't see a hat. You don't see a head covering. You don't see a hoodie on their head. You know why that is? Because the Lord gave an order that when we're praying and prophesying, when his word coming out, when we in the spirit of prophecy like we are now, when I'm hearing his word and I'm interpreting his word, we can't have our head covered.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm going to bring that out, but I want to read this in 2 Ezra real quick. 2 Ezra 6, read it.
2 Ezra chapter 6, verse 54.
Bring it up.
And after these, Adam also whom thou madest Lord of all thy creatures.
We talking about Adam, the first man. He was the Lord of all creatures. He was the first. Read.
Of him come we all.
Every man that's on the face of this earth comes from Adam. You agree to that? Okay, listen.
And the people also whom thou hast chosen.
The people that God has chosen, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians.
Right.
We also come from Adam. Read.
All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sakes.
Hold on. He made the world for whose sake?
For our sakes.
Hey, sis, listen at this real quick. Come here. Come in front of the camp. Listen at this. I got some great news for you. The Lord said, read this one more time. Listen.
2 Andrews 6:55. All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sakes.
You hear that? The world was made for our sakes.
Right.
The blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, the Israelites, these people that you see on the sign, you and me, the people that was made the Lord's on the earth, the Lord said that this is ours.
Right.
Do this look like this all? This ours? No, it don't. Our brothers and sisters be fighting over corners.
Bring it
our
out.
Brothers and sisters be fighting over licks.
Bring it out.
They be fighting over should they have access to sell on the trains. They fight over things that are small instead of coming together and understanding that this world is ours.
Right.
This world ain't the white man's.
Right.
This world ain't the Chinese man's.
Right.
This ours.
That's right.
Well, why don't we benefit from it? Why don't we benefit from our earth? Why we gotta pay for water that falls free from the sky? Why we gotta pay rent? Why we gotta do these things? Why do we have to have permission to drive cars on our streets? Do you live? Do you pay rent where you live? Some man come into your house, kick his feet up, tell you, go to the bathroom. Stay in the bathroom. Don't come out the bathroom. In fact, I want you to pay me rent for living in your bathroom. How would you feel about that? He came in your house, he told you to go to the bathroom somewhere where he wanted you to go, and he's making you pay him for him being in your dwelling. How would you feel about that? You should feel angry about that.
Right.
This is mine. This was promised to me. And what I gotta do, I gotta give up my inheritance to who? People that's not worthy of holding this inheritance.
That's right.
These people are poisoning the air. These people are poisoning the earth. It's hard to grow products that's nutritious because they're not treated according to how God said it's treated. We're supposed to get the land a rest.
Right.
There's a lot we can go into it in this Bible. If you got time, we're gonna go into it. Read.
2 Andrews 6:56. As for the verse 55. All this have I spoken before thee, O Lord, because thou madest the world for our sakes. As for the other people, which also come of Adam, thou hast said that they are nothing.
You hear that? Everybody that came from Adam, aside from the Israelites, you mean the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, he said that they are nothing. I thought God loved everybody. You ever heard that before? You heard God loved everybody? Who is this on the ground? Who is that? Say it, I can't hear you, the mask on. That's Jesus, right? They taught you that. So he taught the world what? God loves everybody. That this Bible is an all-inclusive book. That if you do right, you're gonna go to that pearly gate and get into heaven. You believe that to be true? Let's break down them lives. Breathe.
As for the other people, which also come of Adam, thou hast said that they are nothing, but be like unto spittle, and has likened the abundance of them unto a drop that falleth from a vessel.
I want you to pay attention to what's happening. The Lord said, this is Ezra speaking, he said, the Lord always said that these other nations outside of us, they nothing. In fact, they so much nothing that you can compare them to spit. You ever spit out your mouth before? I spit plenty of times. I spit before I even came up here. I don't even know where it's, I don't even care about the spit. That's how he feel, that's how our Lord feel about these other nations.
That's right.
Why should our people feel any reverence to them when our Lord don't even care about
them? Right.
Our people dye their hair to look like them.
Bring it up.
Our people straighten and perm their hair to look like them.
Bring it
when God don't even care about them.
Right.
When we got the most famous attributes, the most world-renowned beauty, curly hair, curly kinky hair. The most beautiful hair, that's God's hair.
Yes, right.
God don't care about these other nations. Let's not try to pattern ourselves after them, asking for power. Right. Asking for black power. Black power don't exist. Black power is derogatory to our people. It's telling y'all to embrace something that don't exist. In the state that our people are in right now, black power cannot exist. Israelite power exists.
Yes,
God's power exists.
Yes,
give me that. We're going to go to Corinthians for my brother, and then we're going to show her how to get to heaven. All right? You got me? Because I want you to understand, everything we're doing here is to teach our people how to bring forth the kingdom of heaven.
Cool.
Right? Free.
First Corinthians chapter 11.
Verse 3.
But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonors his head.
So I want you to hear that. There's a hierarchy, right? It ain't just us out here speaking whatever it is we want to speak. We coming out here in order. We got a hierarchy. We got the Most High God. We got Christ. We got man and then woman. That's the order. That's the divine order. Somehow, some way, that order got broken up, and we started thinking that it's 50-50, woman and man. No, it's a hierarchy. Now listen to what we're supposed to do in acknowledging that hierarchy. Read.
Every man praying.
You hear that? Every man praying or what?
Or prophesying.
Or prophesying. Revelation 19. Or prophesying. Read.
Revelation 19 verse 10.
So go back to Corinthians, whole Revelation 19, we're going to jump right over to it.
Verse 4. Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head.
Who is your head? Who is my head? Who is our head as men? Christ. Christ is our head, right? So to have our head covered as men, we're doing what? We're dishonoring. You ever go to court before? What do you have to do if you had your hair covered when you go into court? Why? What does that mean? It's a sign of respect. You step into that man's building, he demands that you respect him.
Bring it up.
The Most High demanded it first.
Bring it up.
The Most High said, whenever we conversing and going back and forth, we talking about prophecy, guess what? Uncover that head. That's it. Let's read.
Verse 5. But every woman that prayeth or prophesied with her head uncovered, dishonored her head.
You hear that? So right now you're putting yourself on equal platform with the woman, because she's in order. She has her head covered while the word's coming out. You got your head covered, you put yourself on par with the woman. Are you a woman, brother? No, you're not. So right now you need to uncover your head. All praises, all praises. Now that's the true sound of repentance. Hearing the word, understanding the word, and doing the word. All praise to the Most High. Let's continue on our journey to learn how to get to the kingdom of heaven.
Revelation chapter 14, verse 12. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus.
You hear that? We are the saints. We, the children of Israel, we are the saints. We cannot just have the faith in Christ. We also have to keep the commandments. Real quick, what's your name? Take the mask off, I can't hear you.
Donald,
you got a question, Donald? We're going over who the Israelites are, and we're about to go over how to get to the kingdom of heaven. We've been bringing out certain laws to show our people that these are the things that are required if you call yourself a lover of God. Christ said, if you love me, keep my commandments. You love God?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to keep these commandments. We're going to show you how to keep the commandments. What's your question?
I was trying to find a
reason for this, right? Who that is? We're going to get into that, all right? Stick here. Don't go nowhere. We ain't going nowhere. It ain't freezing. We got some time. We're going to be here. Read.
Matthew 19, verse 16.
Bring it out.
And behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good things shall I do that I might have eternal life?
You hear that? You want to get to the kingdom of heaven. That's what this brother's asking Christ. What shall I do? What good thing do I need to do to get to the kingdom of heaven? Read.
And he said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one.
You hear that? He first gave an example, or he first showed you physically without even telling you, this is the spirit you should embody. You should be humble. somebody may see you as somebody that's up here, but you say, nah, I'm right down here with you. I'm not what you think I am. Only good is God. That's what we're trying to show you. Don't look at us like we special, man. We different because we know this truth. We trying to get y'all on this side so y'all can know this truth too. But humble down to God. Okay? Humble down to God. Read.
Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one. That is God. But if thou wilt enter into life, keep the commandments.
You want to enter into the kingdom of heaven? You want life eternal? Keep the commandments.
Right.
What do we found the commandments at? Devil, right?
Yeah.
What do we found the commandments? If you don't know, it's all right. That's what we're here for. We're going to teach you. You don't know? All praise. We're going to teach you. What do we find the commandments of God? Because it's important. You want to get to the kingdom of heaven. He told you you can get to the kingdom of heaven, but he didn't tell you how. And if he did tell you how, it must have slipped your mind. You got to make sure it sticks into your mind. How do you get into the kingdom of heaven? Read that again.
Keep the commandments.
We got to keep the commandments if we want the kingdom of heaven. You hear that, my brother? You hear that? Let's see how many gates there are in the kingdom of heaven. Because they told us if we do right, we love everybody, and we kiss his ass, guess what's going to happen? We're going to get to the kingdom of heaven. We're going to get to the pearly gate. Let's see if that's true. Read.
Revelation chapter 21, verse 12.
Bring
it out. It had a wall, great and high, and had 12 gates.
We talking about the kingdom of heaven. It had how many gates?
12 gates.
Real quick, I'm going to give y'all a clue. Why do y'all think it had 12 gates? Why did it have 12 gates? Why isn't it one gate like they taught us in the Christian church?
Get up! Get up.
Because those gates belong to somebody.
Right.
Those gates don't belong to just anybody. And you got to know who you are so you can figure out which gate you got to go into.
Right.
This is not an all-inclusive book. This book is not for the so-called white man. It's for the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Right. This is your true heritage.
Right.
If you want to learn how to get to the kingdom of heaven, step forth to the prophet.
Right.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.